Good morning. Today let us discuss regarding some questions in how do organisms reproduce. So first question, what is the importance of DNA copying in reproduction? Why DNA copying should be there during reproduction? You know, DNA is the deoxyribonucleic acid. It is the genetic material found in chromosomes. Okay, so it is present in the nucleus of a cell. So DNA carries the information from one organism to organism. So how do they do? So while carrying information, that is the site for making proteins. DNA forms RNA, from RNA proteins are formed. Okay, the proteins, it leads to the specific type of body design. So that's why the DNA molecule that determines the body design of an individual. So DNA, it gets transferred from parents to offsprings. How do they transfer? It is transferred by means of gametes. So that's why the offsprings are looking similar to parents. Okay, children. So DNA, the diagram it shows here, DNA, it forms proteins. So then from there, the proteins, it gives you the body structure. So that's why the DNA copying is much important in organisms. Next question. So why is variation beneficial to the species but not necessary for the individual? It is beneficial to a species but not much necessary for the individual. Why is it like that? So variations are beneficial to the species than individual. For species also needed and individual also needed. When you compare, it is more beneficial to species. So why is it? Because sometimes for a species, the environment conditions may change. So there can be some problems. The environment can change. It can be dry or hot. Like that, it can change in varying manner. Okay. So in that condition, the survival of a particular species, it becomes difficult. In that condition, for example, a temperature of water, it increases suddenly. So most of the bacteria living in that place will die. So if there are variations, some are showing resistant to heat, some are not resistant to heat. So in the high heat condition, so which can survive under high heat condition will survive. So in case if there is no variation, all will die away. So if variations are there, the organisms showing better variations will be selected by the nature, and it will mainly they will know what they will do. So the particular selected species will multiply and that will be favored by the nature. Okay, so that's why the variations are beneficial to species. So it helps in the survival of the species. Okay, and the third question, how does binary fission differ from multiple fission? So in binary fission, a single cell divides into two halves. Okay, so you see here the amoeboid undergoing division. First there is nuclear division, one nucleus divides into two, then later, so then both the nuclei, it enter into two cells, and there is cytoplasmic division. The cytoplasm divides and two daughter cells are formed. So this diagram is repeatedly asked question in board exam, children, so study thoroughly. So next question, the next continuation of the question, that is multiple fission. What happens here? A single cell, it divides into many cells. Okay, so there one cell divides into two. So here one divides into many. So this plasmodium is the example. So amoeba also can divide by multiple fission, but when it divides, it will do under unfavorable conditions. Otherwise amoeba, it prefers binary fission only. Okay, so during unfavorable condition, most of the organisms, they will do multiple fission. So but paramecium, always they do by multiple fission only, that is malarial parasite. Next, fourth question, how will an organism, it is benefited, so when it is reproduced through spores? So when advantages, that is, it is simply, it is the advantages of spore formation. How will an organism be benefited if it reproduces through spores? There are advantages during spore production. So what are the advantages? So large number of spores are produced in one organism. Why they have to produce large number? There can be wastage. So that's why it has to produce large number. The spores are distributed easily by air, so to far away places. So when it is being distributed to far away places, then automatically it avoids competition at one place. If all are falling in the same place, there will be competition for food, water, everything. So that's why, so when it can be dispersed. Then next, that is advantage, spores are covered by thick walls. So as they are covered by thick walls, it prevents no dehydration. So it is helpful to survive under unfavorable conditions. Okay, then let us come to the fifth question. So can you think of reasons why more complex organisms cannot give rise to new individuals through regeneration? So why complex organisms cannot give rise to new individuals? So mainly due to regeneration. Why is it like that? So mainly, let us see the answer. The simple organisms, that is Hydra, Planaria, they can capable of producing new individuals. The process of regeneration means what? The regeneration, it involves the formation of new organisms from its body parts. Simple organisms can utilize the method, but complex organism, it is difficult because they have complex system of organ system and level of organization is higher. So that's why they are not able to regenerate the lost body parts. But anyhow, they can regenerate the lost body parts such as skin, muscles, blood, like that they can produce. For example, so if you are having some burn or some in the skin, so then automatically the skin, it is replaced. The same way muscles, if it is damaged, so automatically then blood also, if there is any cut, like that blood also every 120 days RBC and all formed. So like that, they can regenerate some of the things, but not all. Okay, so that is the thing. So that's why the new individuals cannot be formed through regeneration in complex organism. So because the complex organisms are coming under higher level of organization. Okay, children, so next question. So why is vegetative propagation is practiced for growing some type of plants? This one already we discussed in some other way. The answer was there, that the question was no advantages of vegetative propagation. Here the question is asked in some other way. So it is also indirectly the advantages. So mainly the vegetative propagation is the ability of the plants, mainly the plants, when they are not able to produce seeds, so then we can go for this type of method. So seedless plants can be multiplied and easily, when you see commercial production of the plants, so you can produce more plants by this method. Okay, so sugarcane, grapes, sugarcane and all, easily multiplied by cutting, so without seeds. So multiplication is faster by means of method we can do. Okay, children, so up to this we have covered 6 questions. In next class we will cover other questions, children. Okay, so till then you write all these answers, question and answers, in your homework side. Okay, children, thank you, and learn also. If you are having any doubts, you can contact me. Thank you, children.